Yeah, okay, now I'm recording, right? I was just telling you that you have to be very careful, very careful. It's coming all tilted. Camera is tilted or the board, my drawing, anyways. So you have to be very careful in what you do. So I just rubbed off, it was going a bit up. I made it a bit down. It has got a bump over here. Unfortunately, I'll not rub off everything. But then it has been made almost like it should be. 2 power 1 is 2, 2 power 2 is 4. The scale of 2 is right. The scale of 1 is right. 1, 1 gap. 2 power minus 1 is half. So if this is going down, it's going down like this. On the negative side, and this is your half at a minus one. This will come as a half if you see. So it has been drawn up to scale almost as much as it can be drawn on the board. So you have to be careful in whatever you do. And I was telling you that if your parents are asking you to wash the dishes because of this COVID thing, you have to be careful over there also. You have to do it nicely, not like somehow. Whatever job you get, you have to do it properly. Is that clear? Okay. Now, the first one was 2 power what? What was the first one? First variation asked? I'll put it in blue. Oh yeah, what was the first variation asked? Y is equal to?
2 power minus x.
2 power minus x.
No, sir, it was 2 power x plus 1.
Minus x plus 1.
2 power x plus 1 plus
fine,
1.
I wrote that as a second question, my bad.
2 power x plus 1.
2 yeah. power x plus 1 where plus 1 is in the exponent.
2 power
x plus 1. So okay. It's y is equal to 2 to the power x plus 1 plus 1.
Okay, so you're saying this one, right? X plus 1 is what you're saying, right?
Plus 1.
And a plus 1 separately also, right?
Yeah.
Okay, so first we'll do that. And a plus 1, I will do it in a slightly different color. I hope the color difference shows up in the comp.
Not less,
right?
So only blue is a little different. Otherwise, all the colors look similar.
Okay, what about these two?
I know the right one is slightly purplish, but it's still similar.
It's barely distinguishable.
Yeah, it's barely different for me also right now on the board. Okay. Okay. Now, the thing is, to draw this, I know that if I know the blue graph, which is y is equal to 2 power x plus 1, I will do that purple graph also. What will be the difference between this and that?
The second will be one up.
It will be simply whatever values have been calculated over here, one extra value to the height. Y is the height, right? So it will go up by 1, right?
Yes, sir.
Is that clear? Don't rush through the thing. It would be clear with 90% of the people, that's okay. But even if one person is not getting it right, understanding, you ask why this graph is my first target and I'm not even looking at the whole thing. Why this? Because I know that if I know this, I can draw the purple graph. If I know this. Because what's the difference between this graph and the purple graph? The purple graph is almost same as the blue graph, except that the heights are increased by one. Heights are increased by one. If you put an extra 1 in the x plus 1, does it increase the height? This one is a pure increase in height. Whatever is the height, this is the height. 2 power x plus 1 is the height initially, plus 1. Are you understanding? Is that clear? That's called the ordinate of the graph. The height has been increased. Okay? Okay? Now, what is the difference between this graph and the orange graph? I'll say that if I wish I knew this, I can draw that. Suppose I don't want to plot. I don't want to put x is equal to 0 and do it, and x is equal to 1 and do it. What is the difference between this and this? This blue graph is going to assume all the same values as the orange graph.
The only difference is in the blue one, it'll go graph, 1 left.
What?
1 unit left.
It'll go 1 unit left.
Yeah, it'll go 1 unit left. Why? Because the blue graph is having the same calculation as the orange graph. I'll just repeat the last class. Okay. Why it is having the same calculations? Is the orange graph having a 2 part 2 in it? Yes, it is having a 2 part 2 in it. Okay. Somebody tell me where is that 2 part 2? I'll pick up a person and ask. I'll pick up a person. Who wants to get picked up? I think I talked to Anvil. Mihika?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, nice name. Because of the name, I'm picking you up. Okay, Mihika, in this orange graph, I have a 2x2 or not?
Yes, sir.
Where is that?
The 4. 2x2.
Yeah, when x is equal to 2, right?
Yeah.
Right, when x is equal to 2, I got a 2x2 calculation. In the blue graph, I've got a 2x2 calculation or not?
Yes, sir. When x is 1.
When x is 1, I've got the same calculation, right?
Yeah.
So this is like the calculation. This orange graph is like a certain calculation. I've got a 2x1, I got a 2x2, I got a 2x3, 2x4, 2x5, 2x6, 2x7. In this graph, if I want to know those calculations, I'll read this graph. So reading the graph is important. So I will get a 2x1, 2, 3, 4, 5 in the blue graph also, but for x values 1 less. Right? When I put a x is equal to 0, I'll get the same calculation as x is equal to 1 over here. When I put x is equal to 1 in this, I'll get the same calculation as x is equal to 2 in this graph, right? That means the same calculations or the same heights are going to come if I put x value 1 less. That means there is a change in x over here. If there's a change in x, it will get shifted towards the left by 1. Okay? So if you shift towards the left by 1, how does the graph look like? The blue graph, this point has come over here. That point has come over there, right? Right?
Yes, sir.
This point has come over here. This half point has come over there. This 1/4 height point has come over here, right? Get the point? That was your 1/4 at a -2, right? That was the height, right? 1/4, right? Has come over here. So, can you see it is like, looks like narrowing the distance. Horizontal distance is same. Horizontal, if I pick any point, I will have a horizontal distance of 1. If I pick any point I pick, it will be a horizontal distance of 1. Even if you are thinking it's very narrow, here if you see the horizontal distance will still be 1. Okay, I'm not making it because it will look very crowded. Horizontal distance. Okay, so don't make a gap like this. That's all wrong. It has got shifted. You shift it properly. This has to be like narrow over here. Narrow, 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 narrow. Got the point? Is that clear?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now I've got the blue graph. The purple graph is nothing but all these points. This 1/4 shifted 1 up, right? So this was how much of a height? How much was the height over here? Half.
1/4.
This height is half.
Half.
Right?
One
where four. Will it go?
It'll go 1 up.
It'll go 1.5, right?
1.5.
1 up. What was this height? 1. It will go at 2, right? This was 2 height. It will go at 3, right? This was 4 height. It will go at 5, right? Right?
Yes, sir.
What the point? This was 1/4 height and this will go at 1/4. And you'll have a graph like this, right? At the point, all the points have been shifted up by 1. Here you see that this looks a broad gap and that side looks a small gap. It will, whenever it gets steeper over there, the gap will look like smaller. Are you understanding? So this is what you get as a purple graph. So I'll mark on the graph as y is equal to 2 power x plus 1 plus 1, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay. What was the next question? So this was what was taught in the class, that if you have a change in x, you'll have to have a horizontal shift. If there is an addition or subtraction in y, you'll have a vertical shift, right?
Yes.
The next graph was not as such taught, but what was taught was the concept. Yeah, so tell me the next graph.
Y is equal to minus 2 to the power x.
Y equal to, so I'll just draw over here, okay?
So we can't differentiate between yellow and orange.
Please, okay? Y, this graph is y is equal to 2 power x. Get the point? Get the point? And what is required is, what did he say? What is required? Y is
minus 2 to the power x.
Minus 2 power x. Now what do you say? When x is 0, this was the height, right? 2 power x was the height. When x is 0, how much will be the height? How much will be the height?
Minus 1.
Negative of that, right? Whatever was the height, right?
Yes, sir.
So it will be here or not?
Yes, sir.
When x was something, this much was the height. For the same x, now how much will be the height? Instead of 2 power x being the height,
it will
be negative of that, right? So how much up it was, it will be that much down or not, right?
Yes, sir.
For x so much, I'm not even reading how much is that x, 1, 2, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, I'm not even reading. For a certain x, this much was the height. For the same x in this pink graph, it will be minus of that much, right?
Yes, sir.
What is happening? It is getting reflected or not?
Yes, sir.
That's your pink graph. Y is equal to minus 2 power x. Somebody started having a random kind of graph like a wave and all. It's not happening. Very simple things are happening. Is that clear? And not because of calculation. Not because of calculation. I hope you're not getting this because of calculation. Anybody having a doubt in this?
No, sir.
How many got it right?
Me, sir.
I got it.
Privately, you write down. You write down who did not get. It's okay. Write down privately. I should know. No, did not get. I didn't get. Yeah, good. I got one. I didn't. No, didn't get. Only one person said didn't get. Not good. Others? Open up. Yeah, one more didn't get. Okay, anybody else? Okay, the didn't get people. Now, do you understand or you want me to explain again? You can speak up or you can write down in the chat privately that explain again, or you can speak up, your wish. One said understood now. Others, those who said didn't get, what is it? Didn't get this one. Now you understood. Okay. This one is basically, if you see, instead of x, it's x plus 1. In your mind, you'll say instead of x, like it was a fx. Therefore, we started with fx. Fx was 2 power. Sorry. Fx was 2 power x. What is the f of x plus 1? 2 power x plus 1. Instead of x, it was x plus 1. Fx graph was given to you. You don't care it is this. Suppose I had never given that this is this. Still you can draw. The point is I gave you 2 power x so that you can just cross check this and that. Okay. If I gave you that this is a certain graph called fx, then what will be the graph which is f of x plus 1, it will be this graph. The reason is, and what is that fx, God knows. The reason is, by God, if I just plot it like this, hardly anyone will be able to find out what was the fx. Doesn't matter. The reason is that when I want a f0 value, I know from the graph. What is the f0 value? In the orange graph, f0 is when I put x0. When I put x0, f0 is 1. Now I have to plot a f0 here in the y graph, in the yellow graph, in the blue graph, I have to plot a f0. What do I do? I'll get a f0 calculation. I will get a f0 calculation if I put my x value as
minus one.
For x minus 1, I'll get the f0, and f0 from here I know is 1. F0 I know is 1. From the orange graph, I know f0 is 1. So when I put x as minus 1, f of minus 1 plus 1 will give me f0 value, and I'll get the same thing. So instead of getting a 1 height here, I'll get a 1 height there. And that is how you'll plot out all other points. And hence, giving it in this format is my aim. That you don't have to care what the graph was, whether it was a 2 power x or x cube or this or that. I don't care, because you don't have to go into the calculation. You have to read the graph. But if I start giving you like this, maybe you get little tossed off that what is happening. With a value given, you might be able to put one or two values and check out that, okay, this is what is happening. And since function was introduced for the first time in the previous class, I didn't give you like this. Otherwise, this purple graph question is, what is the purple graph question? If y is equal to fx, can anybody tell me what is the purple graph question in terms of f? Speak up. If your fx is 2 power x, what is this purple graph?
It is f plus 1 in brackets plus 1.
This, right?
Yes, sir.
Now you look over here. Look at this orange graph written in pink. Look over here. If they say, I have given you this, y is equal to fx values, can you plot this? This is how we did one of the graphs, right? That random graph, right?
Yes, sir.
If I have given you this, can you plot this? Yes, I can. I know f0, I know f1, I know f2, I know f3, I know f4, because I have the whole graph with me. I know f of 1.5 also. F of 1.5 is this height. I don't have to know the numerical value. I just need to know, measure the height with the scale. That's the height. Now you'll start doing it. That, let us take on. Don't get tossed off like what is happening. Let us take on this. At x is equal to 0, I'll start plotting the purple graph. At x is equal to 0, what is the y value? Y value is f of 0 plus 1, that means f1 plus 1. Then you will say, what the hell is f1? Let us go to the orange graph. F1 is 2. In the orange graph, it says that f1 is 2. If you don't know 2, then you'll say, okay, this height is f1. Okay, f1 is that. So f1 plus 1 means 3. That means when I put x is equal to 0, I'm going to get a value 3. At x equal to 0, y is going to be 3. How did I calculate that 3? It is going to be f1 plus 1. How did I know that f1? I knew that f1 from the orange graph, because they gave me f of anything graph. So this is 3. So I'll plot at x is equal to 0, I'll plot a point 0, 3. That is what I plot. That is what I get. Get the point?
Yes,
is it clear? This is what we are doing. Reading a graph and plotting another graph which is based on the value of the first graph. Okay. So reading each and every point and not applying doesn't make that much of sense. While we are reading, we are seeing that we are actually shifting it left and making it go up. Get the point?
Yes,
okay. What was the other one given in this?
2
power minus x. Okay. Anybody? Somebody? Who all got it?
Sir, I got it.
I'll make the 2 power minus
sir,
x.
Sir, I got it.
Yeah, but I want to know who got it right.
Sir, all the x values go to the opposite.
Sir, it's mirrored on the left.
Who got it right?
Sir, I got it right.
How do you know? How do you know? Okay. Anyways, when I start putting x values over here, x0 means 2 power 0 will give me same as 2 power 0. So one of the point is here itself, right?
Sir.
Right. When I put a x is equal to 1, I'll get the same values. What do you put x is equal to minus 1 over there, right? What yeah. minus 1 gave, now x1 is giving you. What minus 2 gave, x is equal to 2 is giving you, right? Right?
Yes,
sir. So x is equal to 2 is same as what was x is equal to minus 2. So this is something like this. It is going like down like this, right? Get the point? Yes, what was here is here. And when x was your minus 1, when x is minus 1 in the green graph, when x is minus 1, what is this whole value, whole calculation? 2 power minus or minus 1, which is 2 power plus 1. It will give you what x as plus 1 was giving. So what plus x was giving will be reflected in the minus x, and what is minus x giving will be reflected in the plus x. The graph gets reflected from here to there, right?
Yes, sir.
So can we make a bit of theory over here? Can you see that there is one reflection happening in the y-axis and one reflection happening in the x-axis?
So if a power is negative, then the graph gets reflected on the other side?
No, not necessarily, man.
Sir, if...
That's not the theory. That is for happening for this graph.
Sir, if x...
If this was your fx, if this yellow graph is your fx, and I didn't even know that what is a graph called, what is a graph actually, y is equal to fx, can you tell me what is this pink graph?
Y is equal to minus fx.
Absolutely right. It is a minus fx, right? Now somebody says that, boss, I've given you the yellow graph fx. Can you plot a y is equal to minus fx? You will say, yeah, for sure, man. I know all the fx values. I just have to put a negative to that. So when this is happening, you have a reflection in... You have a reflection in the x-axis. Can you say that when this is happening, when fx is given, any random fx is given, if I want to make a f of minus fx, if I have to make a minus fx, what will happen? The plus heights will become minus, the minus heights will become plus, right?
Yes, sir.
It will become like this, right? Right?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Can you tell me what is the green graph? If yellow graph y is equal to fx, what is the green graph?
Sir, b is equal to
f of minus x,
right?
Yes, sir.
Instead of a x, you have a minus x, right? Right? We practice that in the functions in the previous class. So if this was the orange graph, was fx, y is equal to fx, what will be y is equal to f of minus x? It's a reflection in the y-axis or not?
Yes, sir.
The graph will behave same, but whatever was minus x will produce a plus x values, and whatever was plus x will produce a minus x values, right?
Yes, sir.
A plus 4 in this, f of plus 4 will be achieved by putting a minus 4 over here, right?
Yes, sir.
And a f of minus 4 will be achieved by putting a plus 4 in the x, right? Right?
Yeah.
So it will get a reflection. And how to do that? So this is like this. This part is going to come over here, roughly. And something like this is going to happen. The orange graph got reflected on the x-axis. Okay, not very clear with this, but I hope you are getting it. Get the point?
Yes, sir.
Is that clear? What was this side? Came this side. What was this side? Went that side. Okay. Okay, so if you start seeing the graphs in terms of this, that means you are not seeing the calculation of a 2 power minus x being done and a 2 minus of 2 power x. You are not seeing the calculation. That means you have understood what is reading a graph and transforming a graph. Are you understanding? And hence the next question was log, which I just hope that nobody will be putting the values in the calculator to actually calculate what it is. Once you have drawn with the concept, you can put in the calculator to verify. Okay, but it is once you have drawn with the concept, hardly you will require to verify, by the way. Okay.
So you could replace log with f and do the exact same thing.
Log is a function.
Yeah, so you just replace it.
Oh, one second.
What?
One second. Just hold on. 1 second. Y is equal to?
Log x by 2.
X by 2 was the first thing asked. No shifting and all. Plus 1, minus 1, stuff like that was not asked.
That was the first one.
Yeah, what was the first one?
Y is equal to log x plus 2 plus 1.
X plus 2 plus 1. Okay, somebody just tell me what will that be? X plus 2 plus 1.
2 to the left and 1 to the top.
2 to the left and 1 to the up.
2 to the left, 1 up.
2 to the left, okay. So you have to just like it is approaching 0. You'll have to imagine a line of minus 2 over here. Okay. Minus 2. So it will be something like this, right? Cutting at minus 1. Right?
Yes, sir.
There it looks like a big gap too. Here the gap will not look that big. Mind you, it's not like I'm drawing it wrong or it has gone in and I should have drawn over there. Not like that. Got the point? Is that clear? 2 to the left and plus 1. Plus 1 means after you have done this, you lift it up, right? You lift the whole graph up, right? Right?
Yes.
Right? Yeah, okay. Yeah, what was the other operation asked? X by 2, right? Slightly different from the others, right?
You multiply the x values by 2.
1 second, just let me have a look at the B part. Yeah, log of x by 2. So who got that? Somebody tell me.
Sir, you multiply the x values by 2.
Yeah, who is that? I? Who is that I?
So me.
Then who is that me?
So it's Vrishank.
V?
Vrishank.
Vrishank. Yeah, tell me Vrishank. This is your y is equal to log x. What will be your y is equal to log x by 2? Yeah, tell me. Yeah. How to do it? How to go about it? Somebody speak up. Who wants to?
Sir, will it move half to the right?
No, who is it? First tell me your name.
Sir, Arya.
Arya. Why would it move half to the right? Now again, why has the concept come to it has to move here or there or up and down? There was a solid reason why we moved it left. Because if I put a value of x one less than the original value, I'll get the same height. It was the reason over here. I put a value of x is equal to minus 1 will give me the same height as what x is equal to 0 was giving in the previous graph.
So here you need to multiply it by 2 so that you get the same height.
What multiply it means? What do I multiply by 2?
X by 2. X by 2 into 2.
So this is Yashmai.
I don't understand that. Maybe you're saying the right thing. I don't understand what you're saying. If you want to explain what you're saying, you keep speaking. Otherwise, I'll ask somebody else. I mean, I really didn't understand what he said. That you have to multiply it by 2. I know x by 2 into 2 is x. Everybody knows that.
Sir, this is Yash. May I speak?
Yeah, Yash.
So to get the same values of y, you need to double the values of x. Therefore, the whole graph should move one unit right to double the value of x.
Wrong. If you move one right, how does the x value got doubled? Gets doubled. Wrong.
So suppose x is equal to 2, then you need
Your mind is confined with the thing that it has to go one right or up or left, because earlier that was done, that's a different thing. It's a different thing. The first sentence what he said was right, but the second statement of yours was wrong.
So the Shinikit, can I speak?
Yeah.
So sir, the distance between the original graph and the log x by 2 graph is from each whole number will increase by 2.
Basically, your voice is breaking badly.
Distance.
Others, can you hear him? Others?
No, sir.
Shinikit, your voice is breaking badly. Can you say again with little like slowly? I think he got dropped off. Okay, somebody
sir,
else?
Sir, I'm here.
Who is it?
Shinikit here only.
Now it's all clear, man. Yeah, tell me.
Yeah. Sir, I said that from the distance between the original position and the new graph x by 2 will keep increasing by the multiples of 2.
Like, give me some specific points. Tell me like how, what we have to do.
For example, the distance between one in log x and log x by 2 will be one in log x, the zero comma one.
Zero comma one. Where is 0, 1?
Sir,
1, 0.
Sorry, 1, 0. Sorry.
Yeah, okay, 1, 0. Yeah, what happened to this?
That and the distance between the next, the log x by 2 graph will have a value of a and take a distance which 1, 1 and 1, whatever x by 2 is, that will be 2a.
Have you drawn it?
Yes, I have.
Can you show me on your webcam? Are you again the window at the back?
Center.
Okay, so this is your y is equal to log x, right? And this point, just for reference, is given as 1. Okay, and I need to draw y is equal to log x by 2. I have various methods in my head, but I'll go to the method after I have formulated it. Like here I said, it's a reflection, it is that, but how do I know it's a reflection? Because I did the basics that I'm going to get a minus of this side and that, and then later I can say that a minus fx is always a reflection of fx. First, I've done the hard work of verifying. So I'll do the verifying and then do some theory that always it becomes this or it becomes that. Now, the basic concept is reading this graph and putting the values in this graph, the required graph. So I will say, let us just start plotting it. When x is equal to 1, what is it? I'm just plotting it. X, y values. When x is equal to 1, how much is y? Y is a log of 1/2, right? Y is a log of 1/2, right?
Yes.
Now, how do I know log of 1/2? I go to that log graph. Log of 1/2 will be, what is log of 1/2? Log of 1/2 is this thing, right? Whatever this point may be, right? That is your log of 1/2, right?
Yes,
that's your log of 1/2. So x1 is going to give me that. Okay. So this point, this height, this log of half height is going to come at x equal to 1. So it comes over here. So that is what is called carefully reading the graph and making. It's not a big deal, but you have to do the careful job. You can't say, oh my God, this is a new kind of question. Is it getting shifted by half? It is getting doubled or what? I don't know. It is getting doubled or tripled or whatever. I'm just reading the values. I wanted it is 1, how much? It is 1, log half. What is the log half value? Log half value is known. This is point half. Log half value is this. This is your log half value. Log half. How much it is? In normal number line, what is it? It is a minus 2 or a minus 3 or a minus half. What is it? I don't care. It's a log half. So at x is equal to 1, the height is log half, which is a negative value. Okay. Got the point? Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Somebody has not drawn the graph. Can you tell me some other point and tell me what's the thing? We'll do the logic later on. That we can do this and get it logically like this. Somebody get hold of another point and tell me. It's your wish. You wanted to plot when x is equal to 0, x is equal to 1, x is equal to 2, x is equal to 3. Whatever you want to plot, you can plot. You have to read the graph, white graph correctly. So what is the point you want to plot? You can pick up any damn point you want. What point do you want to plot? Tell me. Say I want to plot
2.
I want to plot 3.
4.
Okay. Okay, Dhruv Desai, speak up.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, I want to plot x is equal to 3, how much? So what will it be? 3, that's your 1, that's your 2, that's your 3. I'm wanting to draw this orange graph. I've drawn just one point. I plotted just one point. I want to plot the other point. 3, where? I don't know whether it is here, there, where. I don't know. Yeah, tell me.
Sir, I don't know either.
What?
Sir, I don't know either.
Ayyoppa. Yeah, we don't know. All of us don't know. Suppose we have to suppose there's a gun on your head and this, your life depends on the answer. And suppose you have to dig out the answer somehow. Okay. Okay. You can't imagine that situation, but suppose I say that if you get it right, you'll get a big pizza. X is equal to 3. You want to plot where is the Y. That's your Y given to you. Do some steps. No, do some desperation.
1.5.
What is 1.5?
Log 1.5,
right?
Yeah.
It is very simple. X is 3. Then Y is equal to log of 1.5. It's not 1.5, obviously. Y was not X by 2. Now you will say, what the hell is log 1.5, right? Do you know log 1.5? I didn't know log 1 value earlier. Somebody gave me a graph. I know now. Don't know log 10 value. If you ask me to plot 10, I can plot 10. I can mark a 10. If you want me to plot log 10, I don't know where is log 10. So what is that log 1.5? Who is going to help you out? For knowing log 1.5, for saying log 1.5, this graph was not even required. This is asked at x equal to 3, y is equal to log 1.5. Obviously, why is this graph given? To know those values. So can you tell me what will be log 1.5 using this white graph? Yes, Mr. Desai. Using the white graph, what will be log 1.5?
No, sir, I didn't understand.
You said at x equal to 3, the y value has to be log 1.5 is what you said, right?
Yeah.
But I have to actually go and plot it. I don't know the value of log 1.5. If I have a calculator, maybe I'll know. But otherwise, I don't know the value of log 1.5. Then I'm saying that the hint is that this white graph may be utilized to get that value. I'm asking you how.
No, I don't know.
Okay, then we have come back to the super basic of how to read a graph. This is the white graph. When x is equal to 1, can you tell me how much is the y value? And don't read here log 1. I'm asking you what is log 1. Then it is said that it is already plotted. What is it? When x is equal to 1, the graph is here. No, only he will answer. When x is equal to 1, the graph is here, right?
Yeah.
Right? Y means the height of the graph. Y means the height of the graph. How much is the height? 0.
0.
It concludes that log 1 equals to 0. Are you understanding?
Yeah.
Like this, I can find out some log values. Okay? Like log 3. How much is log 3? I will say that white graph may give me log 3 value. When I put x equal to 3, the height must be log 3. Y is the height of the graph and x equal to 3. Log 3 must be the height. So I go through 3. I see the height is so much. I see this is the height. So this height, since I've got a graph paper, I'll be able to read how much it is. I don't have a graph paper right now. So we'll say that this height is how much height? Is log 3 height, right?
Yeah.
Because that was the graph. At x equal to 3, y was equal to log 3. Are you understanding?
Yes. So half of that is log 1.5.
This is a fresh graph. Not half of that. Who said half of that? Now this is a fresh graph. Whoever said half of that, you're absolutely wrong. So just think what you're saying. But I'm just talking to Mr. Desai right now. This is a fresh graph. And you yourself said that to draw the orange graph, at x equal to 3, y value will be log 1.5. That is okay or not? That you said yourself, right?
Yeah.
At x equal to 3, value will be log 1.5. God knows where is log 1.5. But I'm asking you to read this graph and figure out what is log 1.5. So what will be log 1.5? When x equal to 1.5 in the white graph. When x is equal to 1.5 in the white graph, the height will be log 1.5 or not?
Yeah.
So the white graph, what is that? This is your 1.5 in the white graph? This is the height?
Yeah.
So this y coordinate must be log 1.5, right?
Yeah.
So I've got the value of log 1.5 somehow by reading the white graph. But white graph was not my actual thing to draw. I have to draw the orange graph. The orange graph is at x equal to 3, the height should be log 1.5. That means at x equal to 3, it should be this height or not?
Yeah.
So I got another point, right? So I figured out 2 points for myself, right? Is that clear?
Yeah.
Can you figure out one more point for me? Any one point? Like this way, sir, go there. That is the thing. That is the thing. You can take any x. Any x. Can you figure out one more point for me?
5.
Take your time. Take your time. Others who are having an issue, take your time and figure
out. Equal to 0, then y will remain as it is.
X is equal to 0 has got no value in the graph. Do I know x equal to 0 value is how much?
So
the graph doesn't have it.
So I thought it the line connected to y-axis.
No, it is not. Where it is connected, tell me.
Eventually it will, won't it?
Neither here, neither here, never it is connecting. So I don't know. So why do I take a risk with a value which is not known? Second, you will say, if I, what is log of minus 1? When x is equal to minus 1, I don't have a y at all. I have no plotting. That means x is equal to minus 1 is not a valid value at all. Okay?
So, but in the previous graph, I thought it connected to the y-axis.
Yes, and then your thinking is wrong. It is not connected. It almost goes very, very close to it, but never connects. Like in this graph, the yellow graph, if I tell you that the yellow graph was y is equal to 2 power x, when will it connect? Tell me. I put a x as minus 10 also, then y will be how much? X is equal to minus 10. Y will be how much? 1 by 2 power 10. 2 power minus 10 means 1 by 2 power 10. Very small height. Very, very small height.
So it won't connect it.
But it won't get connected, right? 1 by 1024. Very small height. Not connected. I put x is equal to minus 100. I want to go way deep. I'm saying it is going to connect, man. But what's the height? 1 by 2 power 100. Very, very small height. Doesn't get connected though, right?
Yes.
So I can't say that for y is equal to 0 for some x. Y is equal to 0 for none of the x, right?
Yes.
So similarly over here, x is equal to 0 for none of the y's.
Yes.
Okay. It is nearing 0. I mean, x is, when it is 0, then y is almost like minus infinity is what you can say. But infinity is not a definite number. It's just a way of imagining, like far, far off, it might be going damn close and almost connecting and so close that we don't care that it was little off. Okay, anyways, coming back to this, Mr. Desai, help me out with one more point, any one point. X is equal to, can you help me out with the x is equal to 2, Mr. Desai?
Yeah, then y will be 1.
X is equal to
log
2.
1.
Yeah, say properly, man. I got scared after doing so much. Again, you say the same thing. What you are saying earlier, not good. Earlier also you said 3 by 2. Y will be 3 by 2. And then you said, no, log 3 by 2. Yeah, log 3 by 2 was the right answer. Not getting log 3 by 2 was okay for me. That you'll do some hard work to get it. That's okay. But don't say the wrong thing. So when x is equal to 2, answer is log 1, right?
Yeah.
How to hunt for that log 1 value? Mr. Desai, Dhruv, how to hunt for that log 1 value? You will take help of white graph. Huh?
You don't take x as 2?
Yeah, I took x as 2. I got the height as log 1, but I have to plot it. I don't have the orange graph plotted. So how to get that log 1 value? I'm telling you, this is the hint. You have to take use of this. How to get that log 1 value from there?
So can I tell?
No, let him speak now. How to get the log 1 value? So in this orange graph, it is all ulta sida, but in this, it is very plain and simple. In this graph, what is the log 1 value? Log 1 value is the height of the graph when x equal to 1. That is how you have to read in your mind. Log 1 is the height of the graph when x equal to 1. In the white graph, when x is equal to 1, y is equal to log 1, right?
Yeah.
In the orange graph, when x is equal to 2, y is equal to log 1. But this is what I have to draw. But this is what is already drawn. So I'll read from here. I'll paste it there. When x is equal to 1, then y is equal to log 1. But how much is y? It is drawn. Like we don't have to guess. It is drawn. So look at the graph and tell me. at x equal to 1, what is the height of the graph? Y is called the height of the graph.
Zero.
Zero, absolutely right. So at x equal to 1, at x equal to 1, y is the height of the graph, which is log 1, is 0. 0 is the height. So I get to know that log 1 is 0 by reading that graph. Could you have got that value by reading some other graph? No, from the white graph. So I've read the value. Now you have to utilize in the orange graph. So you'll say when x equal to 2, y is equal to log 1, but log 1 I found it is equal to 0 from some other graph, that remains. It's not like it is log 1 is 0 in one graph and log 1 is something else in some other graph. So log 1 is 0. That means at x equal to 2, the height of this orange graph has to be 0. And yeah. x equal to 2, the height has to be 0. So I got another point. Got the point?
Yeah.
Now you have to tell me one more point. I'm just being after you. I'm sorry. But since this point I helped you, give me some other point, man. Some other point. X is equal to say 4 or whatever.
5.
Huh?
5.
X is equal to 5, huh? Okay. So when X is equal to 5, shall I write here? That's yeah. Too much off there, huh? Okay, I'll write here. When x is equal to 5, yeah, what is the height?
Log 2.5.
Yeah, you are getting that all right. Log 2.5. Now, what is log 2.5 in the white graph? Show me. So, at x equal
to 2.5 in the white graph.
4, 5. X equal to 5 is here, right? Yeah, I want to get the height. Log 2.5. Yeah, what is log 2.5 in the white graph?
X. I mean, but x is 2.5.
When x is 2.5, absolutely right. So when x is 2.5, the height, right? This one, right? So this value must be log 2.5, right?
Yeah.
So that height will be there when x is equal to 5 now, right?
Yeah.
So x is equal to 5, I draw back that height. Okay. I get that, right?
Yeah.
Okay, got it. And I connect all these and I'll get my graph, right?
Mm-hmm.
Get the point? Okay, so I've not drawn much here, so I'll not do that. What I've drawn, I'll draw that. Everybody has understood, right? This is the process of reading, right? Get the point?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Now, what is happening to the graph so that you don't have to read like this each and every point and plot? The logical thing, like last time it was shifting right, shifting left, becoming like double on top, double on bottom, reflecting on the x-axis, reflecting on the y-axis. What is happening over here? I'm not going to ask you. I'm going to give you a problem of a graph where it will be more easy to see. Some of you may be knowing this graph, but I'll call this graph as y is equal to fx. Get the point? Right? And what I have asked is y is equal to f of x by 2. Everybody draw it. Read it carefully. Okay, you can call these points as you want some names. I'll call it. Let me just call it as 1. This as 2. Okay. Got it? That's your job right now. Draw a random graph like this. This height also you can call it as 1. I'll give you easy numbers. This height as -1. If that is your fx, if this is y is equal to fx, then what is y is equal to x by 2? Now what Dhruv Desai was doing, you'll have to do the same thing. You have to read it very carefully. Slowly read. and then look at the pattern so that you don't have to read all the points, and with few 3-4 points read, understand the pattern that what is happening. Okay.
So what is that height written at the bottom?
So did you see the pattern? What is happening?
The x values get multiplied by. Oh, wait, 1 second. Sorry.
What?
Nothing, sir.
Say.
So it moves with multiples of 1/2.
What multiplies with 1/2?
It not moves with the multiples of 1/2.
No, 2. Not
1/2.
Sir, this is Aditya. May I speak?
Yeah, speak.
So to reach the same y coordinate, the second wave has to move twice the distance as the first.
Yeah, so multiples of 2.
Y is equal to fx, right? It is actually a sine x graph, but I don't care it is a sine or cos or whatever. Okay. So the thing is, to get a y equal to f of x by 2, right? X by 2 I asked. Yeah, x by 2. Whatever is happening at x equal to 1 is going to happen at x equal to 2 over there, right?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
When x is equal to 2, this one, what was happening at x equal to 1 is going to happen. So when x is equal to 2, it is going to give me the same height as what x is equal to 1 was going to give me, right? Right?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
What was happening at x is equal to half? What was happening at x equal to half is going to happen where?
X is equal to 1.
X is equal to 1.
X is equal to 1. So this thing is going to come here. I can't say that it has shifted by half. Has it shifted by half? No. It has shifted by half, but then this guy has shifted by 1.
1.
What was here has gone there, right? So you can't say it is shifting by half or something. It's not a shift. The thing is, the graph is getting stretched by... Are the heights going to change, by the way? Heights are not going to change. No. Is the height getting doubled or null or halved?
No.
No.
No, sir.
Because you put some values and you're getting the same. The whole of fx is not like doubled or halved. But those heights are going to come when you're putting the x values of double the original values, right? Instead of 1, you put a... Instead of half, you put a 1, you get the value. Instead of 1, you put a 2, you get the value of what was happening at 1. So this curve, if I look at this curve alone, this curve is going to happen here, right? Right?
Yes, sir.
This went there. That went there. If I go to 1/4, 1/4, 1/4 was here. Went at half. Thankfully, it came exact. What was happening at 1/4 earlier is now happening at x equal to half. X equal to half is going to give me f of 1/4. So f of 1/4, this was your f of 1/4. From here, it went over there, right? This was your f of half. From here, f of half went over there, right? F of half was 1 eventually. So the thing is, it got stretched. What is happening at x is equal to 1.5 will happen at what? X equal to 3, right?
Yes, sir.
You have 1, you have 2, you have a 3 over here. At 1.5, it was a minus 1 height. At 3, it will be minus 1 height. What is happening at 2 will happen at 4. So the graph has got elongated this side. I'm not going to do the logic on the left-hand side. Fortunately, it gets stretched on the other side also. So this, what was reaching at minus 1, will reach at minus 2. And what was at half, minus half, this depth will reach at minus 1, that depth. So here also it is stretched. Got the point? Is that clear? Is that clear?
Yes, sir.
With those who is not who for whom it is not clear, you do it yourself by taking at least half an hour of time, seeing each point by point as I was doing with Dhruv last time, 10 minutes back. Do it point by point and see. Invest some time so that later on life doesn't become a hell when all these things are assumed to be like a natural thing and everybody must be knowing it. Later on, it is assumed ki haan, ye toh aise hi hai. What is there to think about it? That time will get, oh my God, everybody knows and I don't. So right now, invest that time. What will this look like, anybody? So by the same logic?
This will get divided by
crunch.
It will be crunched.
Okay. Not shifted. This side will come here. That side will come there. Are you getting the point?
Yes, sir.
When you put x is equal to 1, you'll get what was happening at x f2, what was happening at x equal to 2. This thing, this part of the wave is going to come here. Get the point? So the whole wave is going to happen. I've not drawn everything to scale. I'm sorry about that. Are you getting the point? I'll just draw it. 1 second. I'll just draw it more properly. So in this two, one cycle was happening. In this two, now two cycle has happened. The whole graph has got crunched. Understood, people?
Yes, sir. Yeah.
Okay. So I hope that clarifies. Now suppose I said y is equal to twice of fx. What happens? Now x's are same. Suppose I draw over here.
The y's value becomes twice. Like.
So the height. What will happen to this point? What will happen to this point?
So that remains the
same. So over here.
It is a y. If it this height was zero, twice of zero is same. But what will happen to this height? It will become twice the height. What will happen to this height? It will become twice the height, right? What will happen to the bottom height? Will it go up? No.
Go down. Minus further down. Minus
two. Down.
So up will go twice up. Down will go twice down, right?
Yes, sir.
So here only the height changes and... So
it is right. It is height is getting stretched like this, right? How about y is equal to half of fx?
So
the heights will become...
So the heights will...
Crunch be... like this, right?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Now, these are not to be taught. What is to be taught is how you read a graph. This is application. I can do tens of application. Get the point? So, yourself, you practice if y is equal to fx, things like what is y of x minus 1? What is y of fx minus 1. This is what we did the first time. Get the point? This is shifting forward by 1. This is dropping down by 1, right? What is y is equal to f of 2x? Y is equal to f of x by 2. Y is equal to twice of fx. Y is equal to half of fx. And then we did y is equal to minus of fx, y is equal to f of minus x, right? Right?
Sir.
Today we have covered all of this, right?
Yes, sir.
We have covered this in a bit of detail, then a bit of rush over here and super rush for these. Get the point? In the point, but if you are getting the concepts, then I don't have to do everything in detail. You have to do it in detail so that you understand. Get the point? I'll take a test on these. I'll give a random function. I'll ask you a combination of these. Combination of these means do a y is equal to f of 2x plus 2. What do you do?
Sir,
The length first goes again, constant, then the
y goes up. And then raise, the whole thing will up. Okay, I'll give you a chocolate question. You write the answer in private. You'll have to take, you have to tell the steps. First you do this, then you do that. And in a single message. Don't write 2-3 messages. You do this and in some other message, then you do that. I'm not going to connect the two messages. Got the point? Got the point? Like this, Shreya Anand is writing first and then something else. I can't connect the two messages.
Sir, could you please
I sent it by mistake.
I'm going to give you a question. Like suppose this was the question. Your answer would have been first find f of 2x, which will be the graph whose height has doubled, right?
Yes, sir.
Original graph height double. Oh, sorry. F of 2x. F of 2x is the original graph has been shrunk towards the y-axis. Okay? It has shrunk or crunched is the word you are using, right? Crunched towards the y-axis, right?
Yes, sir.
So crunched towards the y-axis will be the first line, and then that crunched graph lifted by 2. This is how you have to write. Get the point?
Okay, sir.
And in a single sentence.
Sir, I didn't get y is equal to 2 into fx.
Y is equal to 2 into fx. Yeah, what is the problem over there?
I didn't understand the concept at all. I didn't like catch it.
Suppose there was a whole graph of it, of which I'm just reading one point. I'm not drawing the whole graph, okay? Maybe the whole graph confuses me. This was y is equal to fx graph. Get the point?
Okay.
At x equal to, say x equal to, what do you want? The point as, say x one. Equal to 1. Okay.
Yes, sir.
This was the height. What do you want the height as?
1.
Oh, it looks like 1. Okay, I'll keep it as 1. Okay. Then I want a blue graph where y is equal to twice of fx. If I have to just study that point, when x was equal to 1, what has happened? When x is equal to 1, what is the blue y now?
So it becomes 2 comma 2.
How can it become 2 comma 2?
Okay, no. I didn't get it. What happens?
Yeah, you tell me what happens. You have to plot it.
This is Aditya. May I
for speak? A certain x, you'll get a certain y, right?
Yeah.
Choose a x.
If x is 1.
If x is 1, well said. X is equal to 1. Yeah, okay.
1.
Yeah, x equal to 1. How much is y?
If x is equal to 1, y is...
Read the thing, no?
Y is 2 into f into 1.
Into 1, F1 man, F1.
Yeah, 2 into F1.
Yeah, 2 into F1. Yeah, y is equal to 2 into F1. Absolutely right. Y is equal to 2 into F1. Now, what the hell was F1?
F1 was where x is equal to 1.
In the green graph, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, how much was that?
1.
1. So, in the blue graph, when x is equal to 1, how much is y?
Y is equal to 1. No, it's 2, sorry. 2 into f, 1. So it becomes 2.
2. So when x is equal to 1, y is equal to 2, right?
So the whole graph moves up by 1.
No, absolutely wrong. By God, why did I take 1, man? Suppose this height was 1.5.
It becomes 3.
Yeah, so the whole graph goes up by 1.5 or what?
No, into 2.
It doubles, right?
It doubles. Okay.
So whatever is the graph, suppose this graph was, now I'm drawing the whole graph. Suppose this graph was like this. Each point will become double the height. Each point will become, go to double the height. Are you understanding?
Yes, sir.
It's not like it is going to go up by 1. If this was a 3, it will go up by 3 more. And if this was a 1, it will go up only by 1. So this point has gone up by 1, but this point would have gone up by 3. Are you understanding?
Yes, sir.
Similarly, when it is half of fx, the heights will become half of what they were.
Okay.
Heights will become half of what they were. Get the point?
Yes.
So they are saying that it will crunch. And the other one is stretch.
Okay.
That is when you have an operation outside on the whole of fx. But you have an operation on x itself. Then x is equal to half is not going to crunch it. It is expanding it.
Yeah, it stretches out. At the height stage. Yeah.
Like you saw that x minus 1 is actually moving it to the right instead of moving it to the left.
Yeah.
Okay. So when it is x by 2, it stretches out. When it is 2x, it crunches. Yeah. So are we ready for the question? Fastest finger?
Yes, sir.
Could you just tell how we need to type the answer when the network was bad?
What?
The network on my end was bad slightly. Could you just explain how we write the answer in the chat again?
You write in a single chat message and not a two double message. Like if you had to write the answer for this, then you will say the fx graph gets crunched in the x-axis. Okay. And then that graph gets lifted by 2. Is that clear?
Yes, sir. Thank you.
Okay. Okay. I'm asking a very difficult one, by the way. Or maybe I'm bluffing, okay? One wrong answer, the big chocolate becomes a small chocolate. I'll give you another chance to answer. But the first right answer is having the biggest chocolate. The second right answer is having the smaller chocolate. Get the point? If the second right answer is after your wrong answer, then you'll get a small chocolate. Okay, I'll do that calculation for you. Okay. Okay. Y is equal to fx is given to you some graph. What would be y is equal to f? How complicated shall I make it, man? 2x plus 3 minus, okay, check it. Since we are online, just tell me so much. Privately, fastest finger, warning, don't rush up. If you rush and give, your answer is bound to be wrong. Take my word for it. The question is, if y is equal to fx is given, y is equal to f of 2x plus 3 will be what? Vrishank, absolutely wrong answer. So you lose a chocolate. Or the people are just giving the answer. I'm pretty sure I don't even have to read the answers if it has come so fast, because it must be wrong, or you might be. Oh, so many answers. Arya has given just one line, and some other place his line must be getting completed. You are disqualified even for your next answer, even though Arya Mehta, even though your answer is wrong, you're still disqualified for not following the rules. Okay, so let me read the answers. Dhruv Desai says gets crunched and moves to the right. Like how much it moves, you have to tell me. How much it gets crunched, you have to say, like it gets crunched by twice or something. So I'm not bothering about that. How much, but how much it moves, you have to tell me. It's not like it crunches and moves. And somebody says, that that it goes somewhere. That is not an accurate answer. It goes some, I know it goes somewhere. Something happens to it. It's not an answer. Yash is wrong. Abhinav is wrong. Vishank is wrong. I'm reading in order how I got the answer. So these are like very, very fastest fingers. Gave the answer within the first minute.
Do I have to, can I reason my answer? Because you may not have
Sucheta is wrong. Tejas is wrong. Those who are resending, you will tell that this is my second attempt. If I get to know it, that it is your second attempt without you telling me, then you will not get the prize at all and you'll disqualify for some other things also. Graf gets Tejas is absolutely wrong. That's the second attempt, right, Tejas? No, first attempt. Okay.
Sir, I gave my second attempt. Sir,
is wrong.
Sir,
Prasad is wrong. Mukund.
Sir, Shrinikhet here.
Nikhet, please write in the chat, man. Don't chat with me. Just write in the chat. And this is my second attempt and all. Let me read the answer peacefully.
The reject, man.
Mukund is wrong. Akhila has not even given the full answer. So Akhila is badly wrong because the answer is not there without any specifications.
Sir, I hit the send button by mistake. The rest is there later on.
Gets in, I mean, some of them are getting absolutely wrong. Like Shriniket, you're getting absolutely wrong what it can, what it could be near to what. Vayun Gupta, wrong. Prithvi. There's nothing wrong in getting it wrong, okay? But when I tell you that you need to think, if you don't think much and answer very fast, you are bound to be wrong, then you believe me for the next of the year. When I tell you there is a value to a certain question, it is having a certain value. When I put a big chocolate to a question, it is worth a big chocolate. And if you actually get it right, I'll actually give you a big chocolate because it is worth that. But don't think that I'll ask you a cheap question and give you a big chocolate. I'm very confused. Arya Roop Bose is wrong.
So did I get it right or wrong? You didn't tell.
I'm reading line wise. Graph will. Who is that? I?
Prithvi.
Prithvi, I said wrong. No, already. Prithvi is wrong, I said. Graph. Arushi, how much to the left and all? Not even written. Hence wrong. Abhinav, wrong. Abhinav, that's a second attempt of what? Siddharth. Wrong. Tejas, this is definitely your second attempt. Wrong. Wrong. Ron, Suresh, wrong. Anway, that's crazily wrong, man. Mihika, wrong. Sucheta, incomplete. Sara, shifts 23 times have you written? I guess you mean 3 times.
Yeah, 3 times.
I don't know.
23, it got typed by mistake.
3 times and shifting 3 is 2 different things. Okay.
Okay.
You rather. 3 times means if you are at 3, it goes to 9. That is called 3 times. If you are at 10, it goes to 30.
I meant
shifting by 3 is, means if you are at 10, it will go to 13.
I meant 7. Shift 3 to the left.
No, you can't speak out. Whatever you have to write, you can write. Gets enlarged and write by. Shriniket, wrong. Dhruv Desai. Crunches and moves, you are not even written. How much? Dhruv Desai. Not even written. Disqualified answer. Sarah Rice, sorry, not 23 times. That you have to write the whole message again. The graph is wrong. Shreyanand wrong. Akhil is second attempt, I think. Wrong. Sanya wrong. Aditya wrong. Oh my God! Somebody, man. Somebody. Suchita.
Charles denying at it right.
Wrong. Gokul has come. Wrong. Shriniket. You gave as soon as you gave. Okay. Wrong. This is my second attempt, says Ron, and there is nothing in front written. So what is the second attempt? God knows. So you have to write the whole thing with the second attempt.
Sir, I thought that when I press enter, go to the next line.
Okay.
So, yeah, so that's exactly what happened to me. I wasn't
Yeah,
finished.
That's okay. I understand. Prithvi, wrong. That's the second attempt of Prithvi. You know,
that was part of my second attempt. I'm not done with it.
Oh, part of that. Oh my God. Wrong. Yes. Yes. Is this your second attempt? At 4:57.
Yes, sir. That was my second. I said recent and then I typed my answer.
Oh, recent. Yeah, yes. I think you are right. One right answer. But big chocolate has not gone to anybody. Dhruv Desai, second attempt. I think third attempt wrong. Third attempt is not even allowed. Abhinav, this is your second attempt, right? You did not write, hence disqualified.
Sir, there are two Abhinavs, sir.
Abhinav, sir, I only Chabra. Sent twice. Yeah, I sent only Abhinav. Twice.
Sir, I sent only one, sir.
Who is this I? Let's just tell me.
Sir,
me,
Abhinav. I sent only one.
You said yeah, there are two Abhinavs and then you can say, sir, Abhinav. What? Which Abhinav?
Sir, not Abhinav Chabra.
Yeah. How many times you sent?
So only once.
Okay. Chabra, how many times did you send?
Two.
Then who will write that it is my second attempt?
Sir, I wrote. It's at the end of the second answer.
Oh. Sorry. So I think you are right. But then you are the second guy in the second attempt to get it right. So I'll have to figure out that qualifies you for any chocolate or not. First attempt, anybody?
Sir, but I wrote the answer long ago.
Yeah, but long ago, just before.
Sir, I wrote at 4:58.
Yeah, so somebody has written at 4:57. Man, I'm reading it line wise. What can I do? Yash has written at 4:57. After that, somebody else's message is there, which is wrong, and after that, your message is there. Mukund wrong. Okay. Wrong. All others are wrong, even in the second attempt and all others are wrong. Two right answers. Now, since this Abhinav Chabra is right, this is crazy, man. This five left and all is crazy. How will it? And when you write an answer, I think, then that means there is no work done over there. So, shall I now tell you?
Sir, did you check my second attempt?
Who is this?
Aryarup Bose.
Aryarup Bose. Now I'm done checking the second attempts, man. I'm done checking the second attempts. Where is your second attempt, Aryarup?
5 p.m.
I think Aryarup, I said no, wrong. Yeah, wrong. I said, yeah, wrong. Crunched by 3/2, wrong. Vayun Gupta, wrong. Okay. Okay, okay. Now let me ask you something. Okay, if I ask you something, then again you will take that much of time. But I think I'm almost up with the time. So people are saying that it crunches by two. Most of you, if this was a graph, you're saying that it crunches by two. Get the point? And shifts by three back, right? Right?
Yes, sir.
Right, people, this is what you have said, right? Most of you, you can speak up.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
This is the right answer. Crunches by two and shifts by three back is the right answer. Now speak up.
Sir, I got this on my first attempt.
Yeah, sir, now even you're speaking. I got this on my first attempt.
Sir, even I got.
Yeah, now you're
even
speaking.
I got it.
Good, good, good. Now, this is wrong answer. I just wanted you to speak up, man. Okay, this is the wrong answer. That is what I'm saying. Now, why this is wrong? That even what you got at the first attempt, that even thing is wrong. Okay? Why it is wrong? Why it is wrong? When you have a x plus 3 instead of x, when you have a x plus 3 instead of x in a function, then it shifts by 3. When you have a x plus 3, I write a new function. Y is equal to, I'll call a new function as gx. Instead of gx, if it was x plus 3, g of x plus 3, it shifts by 3 over there. This looks, may look like that. Is not that, is not that, is not that at all. If I replace this and I call it gt, g of t by 3, it shifts by 3 on the other side, on the t axis. Okay, I'll forget, I'll not call t axis, I'll say x axis. This is absolutely right that it shifts by 3. This is not a shift by 3. What is it?
So it's a shift
instead of x, what is it? Instead of x, so what could have been?
Shift 3 by 2 to the left.
So is it shifted by 3 by 2 to the left?
Yeah, it is shifted by 3 by 2, right? What is it? Instead of x, what is it? So what would have been the function without the 3 shift, without the shift? What would have been the function? Say the function was, so you're doing it line wise. No, you said, let me crunch it first. So I'll do the same line and show you how weird you were in doing it, because you're not being careful. Not being careful makes you weird. You said, okay, to know the green function, I wish I knew what is y is equal to f of 2x, right? Get the point? Then you describe f of 2x is like crunched by 2. Absolutely right. Crunched by 2. Absolutely right. Is that clear? Is that clear?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Now you said, okay, I got this function. Now instead of x, do I have a x plus 6? If I call it as fx, f of 2x, instead of x, do I have a x plus 3? If instead of x, it was x plus 3, meaning to say this pink, y is equal to f 2 instead of x plus 3, then this is a shift of 3 to what you described this as. You described it's a crunched by two. It's a crunch by two. I agree to that. And then instead of x, it's the x plus 3. Then you will say that whatever was happening to the x is actually the x values 3 behind. What is happening to minus 3 is happening to a 0 over here. What is happening to minus 3 is happening to a 0 over here. And it is absolutely right that it will shift 3 behind. But this pink question was not asked. This pink question is f of 2x plus 6. If it was f of 2x plus 6, it will shift 3 behind. Because I'll read this as this, that I'm crunching something, and that's that thing is, instead of x, it's the x plus 3.
So will it shift 1.5 behind?
You have to go to the core of the x. You have to go to the core of the x, that I replace x. Instead of x, I put something. So then you have to figure out what did you put instead of x. Instead of x, you put a x plus 2. So this green graph is y is equal to f of 2 x plus, 3 by 2. Did I say 2? 3 by 2. You have put a 3 by 2 instead of x. X plus 3 by 2. Then it is the question asked. Then you can say, that if I know f of 2x, then this guy is, instead of x, it's a x plus 3 by 2. It is a shift of 3 by 2 to the left. Now, if you don't believe me, you can draw any graph of your wish. Mark some points, 1, 2, 3, and check it out how I showed Dhruv how to check out each and every point. And you can check it out. Get the point? Is it clear?
Yes,
this sir. Is like high order thinking. This is like the thinking which would be expected, not like all of a sudden, think and dwell and understand. If you get something wrong and then do correct it, mind you, whether I appreciate or I don't appreciate, it is almost like it is not that much appreciable by me right now. Because in the exams, what are going to matter later on, you think of a wrong answer, you'll mark that. And you'll go back. There's no examiner will say, no, this is wrong. Think again. You got four options. They'll not give you, oh, you got the first option wrong. No, second option wrong. Third option wrong. The only fourth option is left. You'll just tick it off. Nobody's going to tell you. The point is, first thing which clicks to you is wrong. You'll do the wrong thing. You'll go ahead. So you'll get a zero. Whether you had the capability of going back and doing it right, doesn't matter. The other guy who knows nothing, give him 100 attempts and he'll not do it right. He will also get a zero. So what's the difference? So in this ruthless world of questions which comes at a higher stage later on, either you are bang on the right time, right on the first time, or you're not, is what is going to matter. So take your time. I'm telling you, I'm in no hurry. You give me answer fast or slow. I give a chocolate for the fastest finger. I'll say that. But even if you were not speaking, but when you give, it is the right answer. You build that kind of reputation in class 9, that if I give, it has to be the right answer. I'll not randomly fire wrong answers. That kind of habit you have to build up. Got the point? So yes, I'll give you a medium chocolate and Abhinav Chhabra, just because of lag of anyone else giving the answer, I'll give you a small chocolate. Okay? So note it down like chocolate, because I generally sign the notebook, but I can't sign it right now. Now, in that paper, what we have given, generally they are doing shifting and moving of quadratic graphs. Get the point?
Yes,
and what they are emphasizing is on one thing. Like, can you tell me what is root 4 value? What is root 4?
Plus minus 2.
2.
How much is that?
Plus minus 2.
Only.
Wrong. It is only
positive 2.
This is read as positive square root of. Got the point? So when I square this, I get x square is equal to 4. When x square is equal to 4 is a different thing from saying that x is equal to root 4. What is the difference? In this, x could have been either a plus 2 or x could have been a minus 2, right? Right?
Yeah.
But in this thing, it is a plus 2 only. That's the convention that under root 4 is plus 2 plus positive square root of. This is called positive square root of. So if I have to write it in the square root form, what should I write? What should I write from here to there? What should I write? Will this be all right? No. I have omitted one of the options of the right answer, right?
Yes, sir.
This doesn't mean this. So it should mean what? Either a this or a that, right?
Yes, sir.
So you'll have to write plus minus root 4 to emphasize that it could have been anything. So this is this. And this is this alone. Remember that, okay? Because I see people making a lot of error. Got the point?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So when I say y square is equal to, say, x, then y is equal to
plus minus root of x.
If I plot this graph, the graph comes like this. At any x, y is either a plus root x or a minus root x. This is plus root x and this is a minus root x. Got the point? Got the point?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
But if I ask you to plot y is equal to root x, then what's the graph? Only the top one, right?
It will be the top one.
Only the top one. Got the point? Is that clear?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, so sometimes they're just getting the top part and doing some operations on that. In that root x, they are saying a root x minus 1. What will happen? Instead of a x, it is a x minus 1. What will happen?
It will go so 1, right?
Go forward. Right? And a plus one outside. So the whole thing will go forward and then go shift one. Up by one. Right?
Yes, sir.
Right?
Yes, sir.
Quickly, orally tell me. Orally, speak out. What will this be?
Sir, it'll be reflected against the y-axis.
No, this will be not possible because it is negative root, right? Right?
So it's not
even. Take it as I.
It will not be possible because it is negative root, right?
Yes, sir.
Right or wrong?
Correct, sir.
Can we not plot imaginary numbers on the line?
No, we can't plot imaginary numbers. Yeah, it is negative under root, it is right. It is negative under root, so we can't plot it because we can't plot imaginary number. Am I right or wrong?
Sir, but can't x is a negative value and
then so what if x is a negative value?
Yeah, it is absolutely all right. I'm absolutely saying it wrong. Why? Because why could I plot this, man? If I take x as minus 10, can I plot this? Obviously not. So when x is negative, I have no plot. When x is negative, there is no plot, right? Get the point?
So, but in the second question which you have given, that y is equal to root of minus
so,
x.
So, in this one, when x was positive, there was some plot like x is 4, 9, 5, whatever, under root of that. In this one, when x is negative, there will be a plot, right?
Yes, sir.
So, our concept of y is equal to fx was this, then this guy is surely y is equal to f of minus x. Whatever the graph be, it will be reflected. That concept is absolutely right. You put x as say minus 1, then minus of minus 1 is a plus 1 and you'll get a plus 1 value. The height will be plus 1. You put x is equal to minus 4, minus of minus 4 will be plus 4, under root of plus 4 is plus 2, you'll get a plus 2 value. Are you understanding?
Yes, sir.
Yes, yeah. Sir.
Oh, yeah, quickly, I was asking a quick fire this thing. This was a quick fire. No, I want another quick fire. Tell me y is equal to under root, This is a difficult one, man. Difficult one. 3 minus 2x.
So it depends on the value of x.
What will happen to the graph? Compared to the root x graph, compared to the root x graph, what is this?
So there'll be like a small.
Take permission.
So this is Shriniket here, can I speak?
Yeah, hold on, Shriniket. Shriniket has asked permission first. Then. Somebody else? Yeah, Shriniket, speak. I hope you speak it right.
So
ask anything, just answer. Don't ask anything. Yeah, tell me.
There'll be like a small curve at the negative of the x-axis.
What small? What is this answer, man?
So I can't tell it. I need to show it. I can't tell it. I have to.
What happens to the graph? Graph gets shifted, lifted, crunched, this, that. What happens to the graph?
So it is similar to y is equal to root minus x, except for the fact that there'll be a small value of 1 bulge in the. Can't show it.
No, it's wrong. Good that you can't show. That will be a waste of time. Whatever you're saying is wrong. Think, I tell you, if I give you a proper question, you have to do a proper thinking. I've already told you. Shallow thinking, shallow answers are not going to help. Shallow thinking, shallow answer, not acceptable.
Sir, could you repeat the question? I got disconnected.
Think, and don't get it is okay. But keep thinking.
Sir, could you repeat the question?
Y is equal to root x is given to you. Comparing this to this, what will you say that what has happened? The pink graph got this and then got that and then got that.
So this is Abhinav. Can I speak?
Yeah, fast.
Sir, in the negative side, I'll move 1.5 left and in the positive 1.5 right.
There is no negative and positive side. There is only one side to the graph, right? This was your root x graph, right? This pink graph was this graph.
Oh, only for that.
What only for that? That is that graph. You're saying this will go there and that will go there. There is nothing there, man. What is going to happen to this pink graph is the question. Think and tell. Think. Don't have to tell it wrong.
This is Shreya. Can I speak?
Yeah, Shreya.
Sir, I think it will move 1.5 to the right and it'll get scrunched up.
How much? Crunched, how much? One, what? This will? Wrong. Answer is wrong, by the way.
Sir, may I speak? This is Arya Roop.
Yeah.
Sir, it will get, means. Crunched by two times crunched, and it will be 1.5 units towards the left.
Towards the left. You're wrong.
Sir, this is Tejas. May I speak?
Yeah.
Sir, I think it will be crunched 2 times horizontally, and it will be crunched vertically root 3 times.
Absolutely wrong. Absolutely wrong.
Oh, this is
why Sangeeta. Do you think that God knows? Yeah, then.
So this is Sucheta. May I speak?
Yes.
So it will be reflected across the y-axis and crunch 2 times and move 1.5 times to the right.
Absolutely right. What's your name?
Sucheta.
Sucheta. Chocolate. Medium chocolate. Absolutely right. First thing, I'll read it. Like this. Y is equal to root minus of 2 minus of x by 2. I mean, I'm just don't have the time, so I'm not writing in steps. This is what the graph is. Instead of x, it's the x minus 3 by 2. So what was that graph? Who's instead of x, it is the x by, so if I say, I know, this is the asked graph. I say, if I know this graph, I can comment on that graph, right? For this graph, I will say, if I know, say a minus x or 2x, whichever, say 2x graph, I'll comment on that graph. Get the point? And for that graph, I'll say if I know pink graph. So what is this? The pink graph crunched by 2. Okay. Then reflected, because instead of 2x, it is a minus 2x, reflected here. Or she said reflected here and then crunched. That's okay. So I got this one. Once I got that one, I'll say no, boss, instead of x, it's a x minus 3 by 2. That makes this, mathematically, that makes this as this. So instead of x, it's a x minus 3 by 2. So minus 3 by 2 means after crunching, you have moved it 3 by 2 forward. And if you don't believe me, you can, this is a plottable thing, plot it out for x is equal to 0, x is equal to 4, x is equal to 9, plot it out and check out what we are saying. Got the point? Repeat this part, repeat the video for yourself, understand, because concepts are simple and easy that it becomes crunch, this and that. If I practice a lot, you will memorize the steps, which I don't want to. If I give you 10 questions of the kind, you will memorize. Okay, I have to do this and then and that, but you'll not apply. I'll not practice, I'll not give you 10 questions on this. I'll straight away give you a question in the exam. So whatever you have to practice with the video what I've given over here.
Sir?
Yeah.
So why does it get reflected?
Negative.
Now you have to answer that yourself. Why this gets reflected when you are doing this?
Oh.
Why?
Okay. Yeah, now I got it. Okay.
Because instead of x, you put a minus x value, it will give the same results. So this is this. So you have to first mathematically link the question asked to as close as this and not in one go. Not in one go. This was the link. So any link, if I say, sir, why does it become crunched by 2? And I'll ask you, look at this. Why should not become crunched by 2? You'll say, yeah. Then you'll say, why it gets reflected? I'll say, look at this. Then you'll say, yeah. Then you'll say, why 3 by 2 to the right and not left? I'll say, look at this. Instead of x, it's the x minus something. So it is 3 by 2 to the right, not the left. You'll say, yeah. The point is whether you are able to write these steps or not in your head or mathematically. That's the point. This question is this question mathematically. You open up the bracket minus 2x, minus of minus 3 by 2 is plus 3 by 2. That's the thing. Okay. Shall we call it a day? Bye-bye then.